If you are using Fillout, there's a good chance that you're processing payments through forms. And if that's the case, you will want to know how to calculate the total that you want your users to pay. Well, in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to do this very thing, but more importantly, how to integrate that with some page logic so that under certain conditions, we show particular parts of our form. If learning more about this very feature in Fillout is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is GAP Consulting. It's our mission to help you get the most out of your no-code tools so that you can build amazing no-code solutions. And in this video, as I said, we're going to be looking at Fillout and taking a look at their variables, their price calculations. But before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for some free automation training. If you're new to no code, or if you've been at it for a while, you will know that the value in no code is being able to do all those repetitive tasks in the background, thanks to no code automation. I've put together a training so that no matter what tool you're using, you can start building amazing no code automations and really unlock this superpower. Grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. I welcome you to follow along in your own Fillout account. If you're not already a Fillout member, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and sign up. And if you would use our affiliate link that I'll put with this video, it would be a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. Now let's hop on into my screen. And here I am. I'm going to be creating a new form. So I just say make a Fillout. And in our case, I'll just go with a blank form. I don't necessarily want to start with a template per se. I'll pick my theme. Of course, these are fully customizable, but I'll go with the eco-friendly and I'll create the form. We'll give it a name. This will be test form and continue. Now, the thing about Fillout is we can navigate all these different pages however we would like. So the first thing we're going to do is ask our users, what are you buying? What is the item? And then how many of that thing? And on our second page, we're going to create a checkout, which says, hey, we're taking the product of the quantity times the price of whatever you picked. And you're going to pay that right then in the checkout. And then the third page will be a conditionally visible page based on the total that they are paying. So if they pay $1,000 or more, then we'll show them a third page, which like has some additional consent and takes a signature or something like that. So this is really just an example to highlight the different features here within Fillout. Let's go ahead and dive in. So number one, we need a drop-down list where people can select the type of item they are buying. So let's go with a drop-down here. And we will have, let's say, three different things that we sell. We'll sell trees, we'll sell bushes, and we'll sell grass. So let's go ahead and add these three different options here. And of course, this is pretty basic. I'm just using silly examples to kind of get the point across. You can add whatever you'd like here. And of course, we have a lot of options on how we are showing this. So in our case, we might decide we want it to be half width and only take up a section of the page. That way we can put the next question, which is the quantity, right next to it. And of course, we want to put this in here. So we'll say, what item are you buying? And just like that, we have our first section. You can see here the three different options that we've added on the right-hand side. We can also apply default values, make things required, etc. In fact, this is a good practice because we do want to make sure that somebody always tells us what they are buying. Otherwise, we can't perform a calculation on the next page. So the next part is going to be a number field. We're going to add our second piece here. And in our number field, again, we'll make it half width and move it up next to our other field. And here we're going to say, how many do you want? And of course, we can add some validation to this, which is a nice feature as well, where we say, for example, that by condition, you can't buy more than 100 of something, right? So we might say that how many is less than 101. And so if someone were filling out this form and said 150 and tried to fill it out, when they click submit, they're going to get an error here that says you didn't quite meet the conditions of our validation that we set up here. So now that we've got our first two questions, let's now build our calculation. And the way I get here is to go down to the logic component, and up on the top center of the page, we have our calculations. And so we want to calculate the price that is due. And so we will just create a new variable called price, and it will be a number, and we'll create the calculation. So the price is going to be the price of the item that they chose, whether it's tree, bush, or grass. And so we will use the new rule here and say, conditionally, this will be the case. If they are buying equals trees, then in that condition, that is our first condition, then we will say the value is, let's say, 100. So maybe we charge $100 per tree. So we will take... We can either add it, we can multiply, or we can just assign the value, which I'm good with. You might also want to start with an initial value. That way, just in case somebody submits a form that doesn't have a condition met here, that is to say, there's not something that's in our system that we're building, we want to make sure they don't get it for free. So maybe you say something like $1,000 is your default, but it will be updated given that it meets this condition. So let's now set a second rule. The second rule will be something like, well, if they buy, and again, we're saying, what item are you buying? If that is equal to bushes, well, then maybe we charge 50. So we'll go 50, and we're not going to add, we're going to assign. And then lastly, we're going to pick the third and final item in our inventory. We will say add condition, if they are buying is equal to grass, and maybe grass is 25. So now we're able to come up with the price variable. But we're not done. We are going to multiply the price by the quantity, right? So we have to build another calculation now, which is going to be the total. And of course, this will also be a number. And here we're going to say there is, let's say again, an initial value of 1,000, but the rule that we want to establish, and this will always happen, right? We are going to assign the price. So let's find that. And here when we open up, by default, we're seeing the different fields in our form. We're going to go to the calculations here, and this is where we already built the calculation of price. So we're going to assign the price, and now, in addition to that, and this will always happen as well, we will multiply by the quantity. So here we're going to say how many. So the variable that was filled out on the how many question, whatever number that is, will be multiplied by whatever price we calculated based on the item they chose, and we're good. So now we've built our calculations, we can put in our Stripe integration where we accept payment. So we've now been able to calculate the total, right? And so we'll come down here, we will add a new page, and it will be a payment type page. So you can see we can collect payments with Stripe. This will be a one-time payment, and we'll just say goods sold. And the price here is where we're going to bring in our variable. So we add our reference, we look at our calculation, remember to find the calculation, and we're gonna plug in the total. We're gonna add that payment page and connect it to our Stripe. And now we're going to have an automatic total calculated. Now this 150,000 is what's happening by default based on the calculations that are happening given our inconclusive variables. So when we actually publish this thing, let's go ahead and publish and just give it a quick test. We can open this in a new window. Now, if you recall, the trees, we assigned a price of 100. So we'll pick a tree, and let's say we buy two of these. So we would expect the total on our page to be 200. 100 times two. Let's go to the next page, and here we go. Goods sold brought in right here. We can also bring in the fact that we sold trees. These are all variables that our form is aware of, and we can assign. Now, the last piece here is going to be the logic. So what happens if we want to add a page that we only show conditionally? Let's add a form page here as our third page, and this will be, let's just call it signature, and we will continue. So all we're doing is naming the page. You can see down here, I've got goods sold and signature, and the first page I never bothered to name, but it's a good practice to make sure you're naming your pages so you can stay organized. Now over here on our fields, I'm looking for a signature. I can drop this in and require that the user fill out their signature here. I'll make this a required field, and we could add some verbiage, some text here that says, I consent to this payment or something like that, right? So whatever you want to do, but of course now we want to make this conditional only if the total is over $1,000. Let's go to our logic. We were here earlier just to look at our calculations, but if we click over to page logic, this is where we can assign when we want signature to show up and when we don't. So let's break this connection, and I will say by default, I want goods sold to go right to the end of the form. This is the default path, but maybe I want to also sometimes include signature under conditions. And this is how easy it is. I'm gonna say add the condition, where the total is greater than or equal to 1,000. So there we go. And so now when somebody is paying, we're going to take them to this signature page after they've paid. Or maybe we want to do it before. So we could swing this over here, break this connection here, break this connection, and you know, bring it in here so that we are adding that condition, right? So again, let's set the condition here. In fact, this makes a lot more sense. We'll say that calculation for total is greater than or equal to 1,000, and we are good. So from here, let's publish this one more time and take it out for a spin, and you'll see how all this came together so quickly. Let's back up in our form, and if you recall, bushes we are charging $50 for. So let's put together an order of 20 bushes. 50 times 20 is 1,000. When we go to the next page, we will conditionally see the consent signature, and we'll have to add our signature in order to proceed to the next page where we are making the payment of $1,000, which was properly calculated. But if we back up here and we say, in fact, no, we just want 10 bushes, that is a total of $500, we skip the whole consent. This is how logic works inside of fill-out forms, a very, very powerful feature, especially used with things like total calculations and other variables. I know we went pretty quickly in this video. If you have questions that we didn't get to here, feel free to swing by our website and let us know. Of course, if you got value from this, please consider thumbs upping and subscribing to the channel. But most importantly, keep on building.